What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. When the term proxy comes up, the first thing everyone thinks of are proxy servers and gateways. In networking, a proxy is an intermediary server that separates end users from the destinations or websites that they browse. You see, if you're using a proxy server, the traffic flows through that server on its way to the address you requested. The request then comes back through that same proxy, which forwards the data received from the website to you. Now, if that's all of its job, why bother having a proxy server? Why not just go straight to the website and back? Well, proxy servers do much more than forward web requests. These servers act as a firewall and web filters, provide shared network connections, and may cache specific data to speed up common requests. A good proxy server keeps users and the internal network protected from bad stuff you can find on the internet, providing and ensuring a high level of privacy and security. Okay, all of that is great, but what does it have to do with today's topic? Suppose the internet is a class in your application, and every time a user tries to connect to a particular website, he or she can create an instance of that class called the connectTo method, and boom, it's done. For the sake of the example, we will be printing out some text, but feel free to do whatever you want within this method. Now, a new requirement for this internet class is to restrict access to a couple banned websites for particular users. However, if we restrict access to these websites within the internet class, no one will be able to access them all over the internet ever. So, what we need is kind of an intermediary server, a proxy, that checks the user request among a list of banned websites, and if the user tries to access any of these websites, an access denied error will pop up, for example. See, that is exactly what the proxy pattern is all about. This pattern is a structural design pattern that lets you provide a substitute or placeholder for another object. It controls access to the original object, allowing you to perform something before or after the request reaches the original object. Let's take another example. Speed of access and caching. Suppose you have a video downloader class. This class takes the name of the video you want to download, then connects to YouTube, downloads the video, retrieves all its metadata and the download location corresponding to that video, and returns with all this info to you using the video object you see. Now, notice how every time we need a particular video, that video gets downloaded all over again, even if it was previously downloaded. To avoid this, what we need is some caching mechanism that stores the information related to videos we already downloaded, sparing us the need to do it again. The proxy class you see here will provide exactly this functionality. The proxy will implement the same interface as the original downloader and will delegate to the original service all the work. However, it will keep track of the downloaded files using a hash map and will return the cached result to the user if they request the same video multiple times. So, if we go back to the same client call we had, you can clearly see that the two videos requested are now being downloaded once each instead of 5 times as we previously saw. Okay, let's go ahead now and take a look at the structure or class diagram of the proxy pattern while trying to relate it to the internet and caching examples we just implemented. First, the service interface, which was represented by both the internet and video downloader interfaces in our previous examples. This interface is that of the service, and the proxy must follow this interface to be able to disguise itself as a service object. The service, on the other hand, represents the actual implementation of that interface. It is a class that provides some useful business logic for our application. It was represented by both the real internet and real video downloader classes in our examples. The next thing you may have noticed is the proxy class, which of course was the proxy internet and proxy video downloader classes. This class has a reference field that points to a service object. After the proxy finishes the work it was intended to do, usually it passes the request to the service object. And finally, the last piece of our diagram, the client. The client should work with both services and proxies via the same interface. By doing that, the client can pass a proxy object to a code that expects a service object. So, to sum everything up, the proxy design pattern allows you to control the access to a particular object by performing something before or after the request reaches that object. To do that, the proxy implements the same interface of the original object in question, allowing it to be used as a substitute for that object. Additionally, the proxy can manage the life cycle of the service object if clients don't care about it, and the proxy object will still work even if the service object isn't ready or is not available. Finally, by applying this pattern, you will be applying the open-closed principle, as you can introduce new proxies without changing the service nor the clients. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.